Hello, welcome to Arvind Singh Academy. This is another session of quadratic equation. So today we are going to discuss few questions related to quadratic formula. We have discussed questions on the basis of method of factorization and completing the perfect square. So now it's turn to discuss the questions related to quadratic formula. So quadratic formula. How do you remember this quadratic formula? What is that? Quadratic formula is what? In quadratic formula, we have learned that if ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, provided a is not equal to 0, is any quadratic equation, then the formula, quadratic formula is to how to determine the value of x, and x is equal to minus b plus minus root under d divided by 2a. And where b is equal to nothing else but discriminant, that is b square minus 4ac. So keeping in this mind, we are going to discuss today some questions related to this. But for this, you need to remember these facts. There are two roots, and roots is minus b plus minus root under d upon 2a. So let me discuss some questions. Then thereafter, we will discuss previous pattern questions also, some difficult question also, but let me introduce today this one. First question I am going to consider here, solve. Quadratic equation is 3x square plus 5x minus 7 is equal to 0, or 4x minus 7, like this. That is the formula. This is what given, one question. What is A here? A is 3. B is what? 4, coefficient of x. And C is what? Minus 7. You have to first calculate D. D is nothing else but D square minus 4AC. And D is 4 square minus 3 into 4 into A is 3 and C is minus 7. So in that case, this is 16, and minus minus plus 4 3 are 12. 12 7 are 84. So 84 plus 16 is 100, and now d is greater than 0, and therefore roots are what? Real and unequal. Roots are real and unequal. Wherever d will come greater than or equal to 0, then in that case only we will be able to calculate the roots. Wherever d will come less than 0, then we will say and outrightly reject that roots are not real, and thereafter we will not do anything. Got it? So how to tell? Now the question is, we have A, we have B, we have C, and we have D as well. These four things we have calculated already. Now there is a formula that x is equal to what? Minus b plus minus root under d upon 2a. So what will be the value of x? Putting that b is minus 4 plus minus d is 100, and now 2a is 3. So I can write here minus 4 plus minus root 10 divided by 6, that is minus 4 plus 10 by 6, or minus 4 minus 10 by 6. In that case, 10 minus 4 is 6, 6 by 6, and minus 14 by 6, that is 1, or minus 7 by 6, 7 by 3, these are the two answers, right? So this is one by quadratic formula. If I am going to solve the same question by factorization, how to deal with? Method 2, by method of factorization, method of factorization, then how to deal with factorization, by method of factorization. So how to deal with this question? If I can write the same question, 3x square plus 4x minus 7 is equal to 0, then product of A and C is minus 21. Now I have to break this so that the product will be minus 21. So minus 21 can have factor 3 and 7. 7 and 3. 7 and 3. But the bigger one would be positive. So we can write it 3x square plus 7x minus plus 7 minus 3, we can break like this. So that would be sum is equal to 4 plus 4 and product is minus 21. So I can write 7x minus 3x minus 7 is equal to 0. If I would have taken x common from these two, there is left 3x plus 7 minus 1 can be taken as common, then 3x plus 7 as well. Because whenever we took minus sign common, the inside bracket the sign will be changed. This is what we had discussed in the last class. So continuing the same, so that some more practice can be made, and using all these facts, we are going to discuss here some more question. So 3x minus 7, 7, 3x plus 7, 3x plus 7 and 3x plus 7 if I can take common, then what is left? 3x minus 7 if I can take common, 3x plus 7, in fact this was 3x plus 7, then what is left from here? X, and what is left here? Minus 1. X minus 1 and that will be equal to 0. So either 3x plus 7 is equal to 0 or x minus 1 is equal to 0. So x is equal to minus 7 or x is equal to 1. So x is equal to minus 7 by 3 or x is equal to 1. So these are the two answers. So solution set will be minus 7 by 3 and 1. That is the answer. Solution set would be minus 7 by 3 and 1. This will be the answer. So this is the second method. We can deal the same question what we have learned earlier by completing the perfect square. By completing the perfect square. So how to deal with? By completing the perfect square. Perfect square. What will happen? So this is 3x square plus 4x minus 7 is equal to 0. First of all, we should divide by 3. So x square 4 by 3x minus 7 by 3 is equal to 0. What to do? Just to recall this previous method, what we had discussed, I am going to discuss this. Add and subtract. Remember what we have learned? Add and subtract square of half of coefficient of x. That is x square plus 4 by 3x, half of this is 2 by 3 whole square minus 2 by 3 whole square minus 7 by 3 is equal to 0. So that will come x plus 2 by 3 whole square and that will be 4 by 9 this side and plus 7 by 3. That will come LCM is 9 and this is 4 plus 7, 3 are 21. So 25 by 9. If I would have taken common, this square is removed, then other side there will be a square root. A square root of 25 by 9 is plus minus 5 by 3. A square root of 25 is 5. A square root of 9 is 3. No need to say this, but still you can have minus 2 by 3 plus minus 5 by 3. So x is equal to, in that case, minus 2 plus 5, if I would take positive sign, minus 2 plus 5 will be 3, 3 divided by 3 is 1, whereas minus 2 minus 5 minus 7 divided by 3, so minus 7 by 3, the other answer will come. So one question can be solved in three different ways, with three different methods, in which one you like, you can solve. But in examination, usually it is not written in the question that in which method you have to pursue. So you can proceed from any one of them. More conveniently, those who are not able to factorize easily, they can solve the questions by quadratic formula. So this formula will be helpful to solve the questions. So whenever there is such questions, you will be able to solve this. I hope you got it. And these three methods, one method one, this is method 1, then method 2, this is the quadratic formula. What I have used here? Quadratic formula. Quadratic formula. Using quadratic formula, I had given the solution. And there, by method of factorization, I have given the solution. Here, by completing the perfect square, I have given the solution. So these three methods will be helpful to solve any questions. Any type of questions, quadratic questions can be solved by these three methods. You must aware with all those three methods and you can use Which method to be used? Now question is that which method to be used and where? This is not a confusion at all. Don't keep in this mind that which method I should use and how I can come to know that which method I have to use. First thing is that whenever it is written in the question, that is using this particular method you have to solve the question, then you can go ahead with that method only. There is no other option, no need to think at all. If it is written, if it is not written, then it is your choice which method you can adopt. But depending upon convenience, you can use any one of them. But this is like Brahmastra, that can be used at any time. Without failing this, without wasting the time, you can use this any time and it will be helpful to solve all the questions of any category, any time. When questions is, but making factorization, sometimes if it is not proper factor is made, then maybe you will be in trouble. Completing the perfect square, that is also always applicable, but sometimes making the perfect square would be more difficult and in that case you will be not able to analyze it. So the best idea is go for quadratic formula. This is sadabahar type, always it will be a type of method, it is a method by which you can solve all the questions. So let me discuss some other questions. I hope you got it. Any confusion regarding this? Okay, so now the next question is solve the equation 2x squared minus 5x minus 30 or minus 7x minus 30 is equal to 0. This is the question. You might be surprised that why I am writing again and again, because this question has been framed, and before writing this question there are 1000 different variety of the questions came in my mind. I have alternate questions and simultaneously their solution also come in my mind, and that is why sometimes I find this would be better or this would be not better. That is why I am revising the question. This question is being written not with the help of any book, it is at instant this has been written. And therefore, this type of things happen. All the previous question were also same. That is was also true. But the solution of that question might create some difficulty in your mind. You are now learning mode. So that is why I write the question in easiest mode so that you will be able to understand it easily. And easily it can be solved. Thereafter, I give those kind of questions as well. So no problem. Now, solution. As far as concerned with the solution of this question, what is A here? Remember, A is coefficient of x square, that is 2. B is the coefficient of x, that is minus 7. And C is coefficient of C, that is minus 30. If I would write D, then D is nothing else but D square minus 4AC, that is minus 7 square, minus 4 into 2 into minus 30. So it would be 7 are 49 plus minus minus plus 8 3 are 24, so 40. 240 plus 49 is 289, which is greater than 0, and therefore roots are real. Roots are real. I can write here. Again, I am doing the same thing with the same methods, and just to explain this, how to deal with such question. Now, again we have to find x is equal to, what is that? Minus b plus minus root under d upon 2a. So I can write here minus of minus 7, that is plus minus root under 289 divided by 2 into a, a is 2. So in that way, this can be 7 minus minus plus 7. 7 plus minus 17, square root of 289 is 17. You must remember this, and if you are not able to remember, then refer my video in which the shortcut methods, shortcut techniques are given, in which you can find the square root of numbers on the same channel. The square root of perfect numbers can be found in seconds, only 4-5 seconds. So that is what you may learn from the website. 2 into 2, that is 4. Now 17 plus 7 divided by 4 and 17 minus 7 minus 17 divided by 4. In that case, what will be that? 17 plus 7 is 24 by 4, that is 6. And 7 minus 17 is minus 10. Minus 10 by 4 is minus 5 by 2. So this is answer of this question. 6 and minus 5 by 2 are two solutions of this question. Now again I am doing the same by method of factorization. Let me discuss one more time method of factorization so that it will be revised again and you will be able to understand it again also. 5 by 2. This is the 5 by 2. Now moving to the method of factorization. What is that? Method of factorization. Yes, this is method 2. Method 2. Method of factorization. So what to do and how to do? Try to understand this. Method of factorization is what? If I am writing this 2x square minus 7x minus 30 is equal to 0, then product of A and C is what? Minus 60. That further can be break into minus 30 into 2, minus 15 into 4, minus 12 into 5, you know. And because the bigger term is negative, so bigger term here should be negative and they must have opposite sign. Sum of these two should be minus 7, so in this case the sum is minus 7, otherwise in other case sum is here minus 11, so it is rejected. Here sum is minus 28, so that is rejected. Here sum can be 60 into 1, that is also rejected. So this is the possible case, and B is minus 7, sum must be equal to B, so it is minus 7, I can write this way only. So in that case, 2x square minus 12x plus 5x minus 30 is equal to 0. If I took 2x common from here, x left from this side, 6 left from here, and if I took 5 common, x will remain here, and out of 30, if I would take 5 common, then 30 must divide it by 5, that will be 6, that is equal to 0. Again, if I take x6 common, then 2x will left here, 5 will remain here, so 2x plus 5 is equal to 0. Either x minus 6 is equal to 0 or 2x plus 5 is equal to 0. If x minus 6 is equal to 0, value of x is 6. If 2x plus 5 is equal to 0, then 2x is equal to minus 5 and x is equal to minus 5 by 2. So solution will be, again, solution set will be 6 and minus 5 by 2. So that will be the answer. Moving with the third method again, so that I will not solve all the question with three methods. It is just a consolidating way in which you can understand all these three methods, how work and what are the difference between these three methods. And it is just a kind of revision as well. So that is why I am solving one question with three methods also. By completing perfect square. Completing perfect square. What will happen? If you are looking for this, then what will happen? 2x square minus 7x minus 30 is equal to 0. So I can make the coefficient of x square unity. What we have learned in the previous video, that x square coefficient of x square must be unity. By making perfect square, the first step is that you have to make coefficient of x square unity. And to make it, I can divide by 2 throughout the equation. So 7 by 2x minus 15 is equal to 0. Now, we have to add and subtract a square of half of coefficient of x. Half of 7 by 2 is 7 by 4. So I can write here 7 by 4 whole square minus 7 by 4 whole square minus 15 is equal to 0. Right? So that will come. Okay? Now, x minus 7 by 4 whole square is equal to 7 by 15, minus 15 will come this side, 15, and minus 7 by whole square, 4 whole square, that will also come that side, right side, it will be positive, and 7 square is 49, and 4 square is 16, so that will come. Now, this will come 240, 16 into 15 is 240, plus 49, divided by 16, again it will come 289 by 16, and therefore x minus 7 by 4 whole square is this, x minus 7 by 4 will be plus minus square root of this, we have done this, 289 square root of 289 is 17 by 6, now x is equal to 7 by 4 plus minus 17 by 16, so that can be further written as what? 7 plus 7 by 4 plus 17 by 16 or 7 by 4 minus 17 by 16. In that case, this will be LCM is 16. So 4, 7, 28. 28 plus 17 is 45. 45 by 16, one answer will be 45 by 16 while other answer will 7, 4, 28. 28 minus 17 is 11, 11 by 16. So that will come something wrong. Why? Let me see this. 7 by 2 whole square, that is 7 by 4 whole square. 49 by 16, that is 289 by 16. And 7, 4, 28. 28 plus 45. So that will come somehow. Let me see, check it, whether it is wrong. 2x square minus 7x minus 30 is equal to 0. So if you divide by 2, then 7 by 2x minus 15 is equal to 0. X minus 7 by 4 whole square, yes that's right, is equal to 15 plus 7 by 4 whole square. 7 by 4 whole square will be 49 by 16, that is 240. Plus 49, 289 by 16, so square root of that would be, oh sorry, here it will be 4. A square root of 289 is 17, but the square root of 16 would be 4 only. So you need to write here 4 only, right now? That terms will be 4 only. So 4, 4 and 4. Now 17 plus 7, 24 by 4, what will be that? 24 by 4 is 6, so that will be 6. And 7 minus 17 is minus 10, minus 10 by 4 is minus 5 by 2. So that will be your answer in this way. And you will be able to solve all these questions by using any one of the method. And that will be helpful to solve the questions. So I hope you got these three methods clearly. And you have a clear perception that what to do in each of the method. Now we will solve questions by any one of the method depending upon the convenience. We will not solve all the questions by three different methods. Just to deal with the situations, just to deal with the idea that there is nothing difference between these three methods, we can adopt any one of them to solve at any time. So, here the one, two questions have been displayed here with the solutions that there are three different methods which can be applied to solve any questions, and depending upon the variety of questions, we will solve any one of them. So let me discuss some more questions, how to deal with that. So here is some question. Now solve question number 3. Solve x plus 1, x plus 2. You have to solve this. Might be possible that you will become very surprised that there are four linear factors and this is not a quadratic equation. Why I should solve it? So let me explain this, how to solve such questions. You can go ahead with one or this two form together, x plus 4 and x plus 1 together, and I can take x plus 3 and x plus 2 together, if you multiply this, what will happen? What will happen? X square minus plus x plus 4x, that is 5x plus 4. And this will come x square plus 5x plus 6 is equal to 840. Now I can take it as x square plus 5x plus 4 is equal to, or even x square plus 5x plus 5 is equal to y. So this is y minus 1, that can be written y minus 1, that can be written y plus 1 is equal to 840. And therefore y square minus 1 is equal to 840, y square is equal to 841, so y is equal to plus minus 29. So 29, y is equal to plus minus 29. Now consider the two cases when y is equal to 29. Y is what? X square plus 5x plus 5 is equal to 29. So x square plus 5x minus 24 is equal to 0. Now 24 is the factor. So what to do? 8 into 3. X square plus 8x minus 3x minus 24 is equal to 0. Or if I took x common, x plus 8. 3 common, x plus 8 is equal to 0. So x plus 8 and x minus 3 is equal to 0. And therefore x is equal to 3 or minus 8. When y is equal to minus 29, in that case what will happen? X square plus 5x plus 5 is equal to minus 29, or x square plus 5x plus 34 is equal to 0. Now here d is equal to d square minus 4ac, that is 5 square minus 4 into 1 into 34, that is 25 minus 4 4s are 16 and 3 4s are 12 and 113, which is less than 0, that is minus 111, so which is less than 0, and therefore real roots are not possible. No real roots in this case. No real root in this case when y is equal to minus 29. But when y is equal to 29, two roots came. So solution set are, although this is a biquadratic equation, fourth degree 4, this can have four roots, but out of them there are only two real roots. Remaining two are imaginary, which we have not to calculate. So two solutions are there. Even you can verify it. If you put x is equal to 3 here, that 840 will come. If you put x is equal to minus 8, 840 will come. You can search it alone and you will be able to analyze this. So for this type of question, what to do? Let me explain once again. You have to make pair with 4 plus 1 is 5 and 2 plus 3 is 5. Such pair will be enabled to help you to assume something. And now this one I have put y, arithmetic mean of these two. If there are two factors, this plus this divided by 2 is equal to y. So that is what I have assumed. X square plus 5x plus 5 is equal to y. So that is 1 less than y. And this factor is 1 more than y. So y plus 1, y minus 1 is equal to 840. Y square minus 1 is equal to 840. Y square is equal to 841, because minus 1 will come this side, it will be posted. And y is equal to plus minus 29. Now when y is equal to 29, what we have supposed? We have put the value. Now that 29 will come this side, it will be 24. Now by method of factorization, I have factored this. And I have calculated this x plus 8, x minus 3 is equal to 0, x is equal to 3 and x is equal to minus 8. When y is equal to minus 29, d comes less than 0 and therefore no real roots are possible. So only two solutions are there, one is 3 and another is minus 8. So I hope you got it, how to deal with the questions. In next class, we will discuss some more questions about the quadratic formula and some tricky questions as well. So thank you very much for watching. Share and subscribe our channel and keep watching. Thank you very much. All the best.